You know, there's gotta be a better way. Yeah. Hi everyone, Christian from MacDon again. I'd like to spend a few minutes talking about header integration. What header integration is it allows us to control all the features of the combine headers without having to add any additional wiring harnesses or switches to your combine cap. So we've had integration available on certain models for a few years now. Kloss and John Deere X9 are two examples of that. What's new for 2024 is all of the CNH, so that's your Case and your New Holland combine headers, also support integrated controls. Now, depending on what combine you have, you may already be set up for this. So we're gonna spend a little bit of time discussing what you need to run integration on your MacDon and Case New Holland combine. You may notice on a 2024 and later Case and New Holland built header that there is a plug that's missing. So normally there would be two plugs. This is a plug to plug the combine in, and then there's another plug for your accessory harness that runs up into the cab. So if that plug is missing, that means that your header is already configured for integrated controls. So in this situation, your only connections that you need to make are your multi-coupler hookup and your large round Deutsch style connector. So now with the integration, all of our electrical connection is through the one large bulkhead harness. So we can now control our contour max, our variable draper speed, and we can also control our stubble light kit. We're in the cab of this brand new 2024 CR9.90. If you've got a 2024 flagship Case or New Holland combine and a 2024 MacDon FD2 header, you should be good to go right out of the box. All right, so the first time you hook up your brand new combine header to your brand new combine, you're gonna wanna go in and make a few adjustments. First thing we wanna do is we wanna make sure that we've got the correct software in the combine. So on the diagnostics page, we wanna go down here and we wanna check. So the lowest version is 36.4.00. That is the minimum software version required for integration. So this being a brand new combine, it already has the correct software in it. If you have an older combine, you may still be able to support the integration, but you may require your dealer to do a software update on your combine. So double check that first. And if it's not at least 36.4, you're going to need a software update. Go back to the home screen and we're going to go into the toolbox and we need to tell the combine some information. Okay, so now that we're in the header one setting, we want to make sure that we've got our settings properly configured, because it doesn't necessarily sense all of the installed options, and you may not have all these options installed. So we want to make sure first of all that our header subtype is FD2 2 series. If we don't select that first, then we may not get the options for some of our other features. So for example, if it's configured as a vari feed or 8090, or on a Case it might be configured as a 2000 series, you want to make sure you select FD2. That's also a good indication that you've got the correct software for integration. Now I've got a couple of different options here. So four knife aft, that feature is not supported by MacDon. Knife position sensor, hydraulic reel reverse, on this one we don't have it installed. If you scroll down a little bit further down, contour max wheels. This machine has the contour max option, so we need to install it. And a recent update is the contour max kit also has an optional position sensor. So depending on which kit you have, because you don't have to have the sensor, you can just have the manual indicator installed. This one does have the sensor, so we're going to select it. Header work lights, so these would be your stubble lights. This header has them installed, so we're going to select that as well. And lateral belt speed control, so this is your side draper speed control. So that is standard on all of the FD2s, so we are going to enable that as well. In the head two, there will be some also some parameters that need to be installed. Reel speed sensor, for example, if it's a 2024, there will be a reel speed sensor, but it's not yet supported on this model of combine. The reel speed sensor is supported on the new CR11 and AF11. So we're gonna say it's not installed. The fact that it's there isn't going to affect your feature. So there's a couple other settings here. You're gonna wanna check with your operator's manual to determine what is correct for your particular header. But that is enough for us to get the integration kit working properly. I want to actually make it work. Okay, I'm going to start it up. You don't need to film me starting it, I don't think, but whatever. So now with our monitor configured, when I engage the header, we're doing this indoors, that's why we've got the grain tank closed. When I scroll all the way down, so lateral belt speed control, if I go all the way down, here is my belt speed. So if I tap on that, now if you can see right now, the belts aren't turning at all. And as I increase the speed, I can fine tune it wherever works best for my cutting conditions. You can put a shortcut to this speed on your menu as well. If you'd like to add that shortcut to your lateral belt adjustment speed, you can do that in your combine monitor. So to add the shortcut, go to Toolbox, select Layout. Now in this instance, you can pick whatever run screen you want. I'm just going to put it on run screen 4 for right now. Any place that there's an open area, or you can rearrange this based on however you want, but find an open area, and then you're going to want to scroll down until you see lateral belt. Lateral belt speed, select that. Now it's in the empty spot. When we go back to our run screens, there's our lateral belt. So run screen 1, 2, 3, 4, there's our belt. Tap on it, and then you can adjust your speed wherever you want it. And you can add that to any screen you want. So now that we've got our monitor configured, so now we can use our native controls to control our header functions. So header up, down, reel up, down, fore, aft, those are all the same as they've always been. Your shift button on the back of your hydro handle plus fore and aft gives us header tilt. And for my new contour max option, it's the same shift button, but now it's reel up and down. Up to raise the wheels, down to lower the wheels. So that's all that's required to enable the integrated features on your brand new FD2 and your Case New Holland combine. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.